Once upon a time, in a deep, dark cave way down underground, there lived a mighty sorcerer. Now, a sorcerer is kind of like a magician, and this sorcerer was a very fine sorcerer. He could do all the very best magic tricks, like changing bats into butterflies, making diamonds out of warts, and changing small black cats into large white elephants. He had an apprentice. Now, an apprentice is, well, a kind of helper or assistant sorcerer, and his name was Mickey, and he could even do a few small magic tricks himself, like changing a teardrop into a dewdrop, and he could hardly wait until he was a full-fledged sorcerer and could fill the master's shoes, or rather the master's magic hat. In the meantime, he had to do the chores. When the sorcerer was away someplace sorcering, Mickey would put on the master's magic hat. But nothing happened. He just fell down over his eyes. And he couldn't see his magic tricks, even if he could do them. One day, the sorcerer had to go out of town to change a two-headed calf back into a stewing pot for an old lady. Mickey, he said, when I return, I expect that big tub in the hall filled with water from the fountain. There's been entirely too much daydreaming lately. Now to work. And he was gone on a purple cloud. Mickey put on the magic hat, far back so it wouldn't fall down over his eyes. His ears kind of helped to hold it up. Now, thought Mickey, who will I command to do my work? He looked around the room and he saw an old broom in the corner. You, said Mickey, in his best sorcerer's voice. You, broom there, fill the tub. And he glared very hard at the broom and he spoke the sorcerer's magic words. Mickey looked, and then Mickey looked again. He could hardly believe his eyes. Surely the broom was moving. It picked up the bucket and swept out to the fountain. Mickey followed, hardly daring to breathe lest he break the spell. The broom filled the bucket and swept back along the corridor, not spilling a drop, mind you, and emptied the bucket into the tub. The broom made another trip. And another. Well, Mickey just sat down to watch. I have worked magic. I am a great sorcerer. And he sort of waved his hand at the broom as it danced merrily by. Hi, broom. Oh, surely, thought Mickey, when the master returns and sees what I can do, he will give me a magic hat of my very own. Mickey closed his eyes and imagined himself a full-fledged sorcerer. Mickey, the mighty master of magic. He fell asleep and dreamed he was soaring high in the sky, way up in the clouds. The stars winked a welcome, and Mickey winked back. Comets flashed through space at his command, and they wiggled their tails at him, and he wiggled back. Why, he just had to raise his little finger, and the Milky Way changed to chocolate, and then peppermint, and then pineapple. Now Mickey was standing on the very top of a high, high mountain, and the ocean was all around, and the waves were breaking and splashing all around him. The thunder thundered, and the lightning flashed, and those waves, well, they grew higher and higher, creeping up that mountain until they got all the way up to Mickey. And do you know what? He was soaked. Well, Mickey woke with a start from his dream. He looked at the tub, and it was filled with water. And still the broom was bringing more. Why, the whole room was filling with water. Oh, stop, cried Mickey. Oh, stop. And he tried to speak the magic words. But he had forgotten. The water kept rising, and Mickey had to swim to the cupboard where he got a hatchet. And do you know what? He chopped at that broom, and he chopped and chopped until he chopped it into 1,000 pieces. And now, everything was quiet. Very quiet. Oh, well, I've stopped the flood. But, you know, I'm really not quite the sorcerer I should be. I just better get the mop quickly and clean up. Suddenly he heard strange noises. And do you know what? Each one of those 1,000 splinters of broom had become full grown, as if by magic, which it kind of was. And now 1,000 brooms were carrying water to fill the tub. Mickey slammed the door. But then what is one small apprentice against 1,000 magic brooms? They broke the door down and rushed over him, carrying their buckets of water. Oh, stop, he cried. Stop. Oh, now I have really done it. And how will I ever explain to the master if I only knew the magic word for stop? Quickly he swam to the library. Maybe he could find it among the magic books. Oh, dear. Now, let's see. I must hurry. Love potions. No. Werewolves, warts, waterfalls. Oh, heavens, no. Where are the S's? The S's, the S's. Sticks and stones. The library was filling with water, and Mickey was floating right up to the very top. Oh, I shall be drowned. I shall surely drown. Everyone in the whole wide world will drown. Oh, what will I do? Suddenly, a large shadow appeared. It was the master. He had returned. Oh, save me, cried Mickey. And the master spoke the magic words to save Mickey. The room was nice and dry, and the broom leaned peacefully in the corner. Everything was like it had been before. Well, everything except Mickey. He was cold and wet, and he was a very repentant apprentice. Oh, what are you going to do with me? Mickey sniffled. Well, the sorcerer didn't say one word, but he took the broom in his hand, he turned Mickey around, he took careful aim. The end.